All right, guys, today we're going to go ahead and put pads in here. We're going to put the rotor on. Now, I got these brakes from Scarebird Brakes. Scarebird Brakes out of New Mexico, Albuquerque. This kit was a lot different than all the other kits that were available, being that this kit had dual mounts. So as you can see here on this bolt, it could have mounted for the high range or low range, which would have been everywhere from a light duty to a heavy duty front end. So it took a little guesswork out. Also, Scarebird sent me all the supporting information I needed. Step-by-step instructions of how to install this. It made it very easy to do. So I highly recommend it. So I just have this caliper hung. It's not tight. I'm going to pull this off. We're going to put the rotor on, and then we're going to put the pads on, load this. It's called loading. And then we're going to button everything up for highway ready. Okay, we're going to use this heavy Allen. And this heavy Allen will go right in there in the back of this thing, and we can just turn it off. Just like that. Backing it off, just like that. Okay, I got them loose. We'll just take them out. Now let's just pop this rotor off. Or rotor, this caliper off. Oh, don't want to lose that. That's an important piece. Just pull it off there. I'm going to have to get both hands on it. I have a large pad and a small pad. The large pad is going to clip in on this side. Just like that. The small pad clips on the other side like that. I gotta have both my hands, so I'm gonna turn you off. They're in. Now let's put the rotor on. Rotor, let's see if it fits. Now let's run some lug nuts down on it. What you're watching now is a real-time event of what I showed you on the other side. So you're watching in real-time how I'm setting up these calipers and this rotor. I'm using a Scarebird brake product out of Albuquerque, New Mexico. Out of all the places that I checked out, these guys were the best. They sent me that hanger, the brake hanger or the bracket, that hub assembly that you see there, and all the parts that go in it, the bearings, the seals, all of that stuff. And they gave me just an amazing amount of information, pictures, you name it, tons of stuff. They gave me a breakdown of everything that would actually work in this application.
Now, a problem I had with another brake supplier is I kept taking measurements, I kept calling them, I kept talking to them on the phone, and they were pretty much saying, hey, you know, these measurements could be this, they could be that, we need exact measurements. And so when I got a hold of these Scarebird people, basically they sent me this bracket with, it's got multiple mounting options on it, so it would fit any one of the front ends that would have come on this car. So light, heavy, or medium duty, which this is light duty. And everything mounted right up, like just super easy. It's just wonderful, man. I had such a great time putting this stuff together. It's really nice when you can put stuff together and you don't have a lot of hassle, because I've had to make a lot of stuff work. And yeah, I can spend 2 hours on the drill press and make things work, but it was so nice that these people from Scarebird put together such a wonderfully efficient kit that all I had to do was assemble it, and it was great. Now, I'm putting a rotor on right now, and that rotor comes off of a Ford Probe. I think it's a 95. So all the years that Ford Probe was in production, the rotor didn't change. So as long as you've got a Ford Probe rotor on this hub assembly, it works fine. Now, this brake system was designed to work with a 1990 Chevy S10 four-wheel drive brake caliper. But I want a larger brake caliper, and it had options, alternatives to that. And one of them was a 1995 to 97 Cadillac Eldorado brake caliper, and that's what I went with. So as you can see, the brake caliper that I installed on this car, or that I'm installing on this car here in just a few minutes, is larger, and I just like the way it looked better, and that's the reason I went with that. Believe it or not, it was just aesthetics. I think the 1990 S10 caliper would work just fine on this car, but I like the look of the Eldorado and caliper. But I can't say enough good things about Scarebird. Just the information they gave me, pictures, they gave me a list of every option that would work on this car for this setup, and it was completely accurate. I mean, there was no guesswork, there was no fitting. It all went together like butter. Now, when we look at the brake lines, the banjo, and all of that stuff going to the primary brake line of the car, I went with some aftermarket stuff because I wanted braided brake lines. Scarebird, you know, they did recommend like Eldorado brake lines, GM brake lines, and all that would work fine, but I know enough going down the road that I could put an aftermarket brake line kit on that, good banjo, braided lines, and just a little bit more flash for me, that I'll, since this is going to be a hot rod here in a few more months, I should have it into some color or something if everything goes right. And but you can't go wrong. If the next car I do, whatever it will be, I definitely will give Scarebird the first call. Now, a lot of times when you're getting this brake conversion kit, you'll see Universal. Don't go by Universal, because it really does depend on your car. Now, if you're putting a Mustang 2 front end on your car, like a lot of hot rodders do, most of your Universal stuff is designed for a Mustang 2 front end. And keep that in mind. If you're trying to do a brake conversion like this, this is an old kingpin front end. It's what they call a kingpin front end. So it's got a lot of steel, and it is nothing like a Mustang 2 front end. You just saw me turn it there. You see the way that's all set up in there? And so it takes a very special bracket to do this switchover. And Scarebird gave me this stuff. Now, all together on these brakes, if you add the additional cost beyond the kit, because I had to buy the rotor, I had to buy the calipers, I had to buy the brake lines, the banjo fitting, and all the little miscellaneous stuff that it takes to mount up the fluid delivery system. We're probably looking at roughly $700-$750 to get it done. That's about what I have in this front end. Now, the peace of mind of having disc brakes on the front of this car is great. I'm going to run the factory drums on the back. It's not going to be a problem. I'll have to change out the master cylinder probably. But that's something to come in a little later time. But right now, I want to do that. But they even told me the size of the lug nuts in this kit. And I know it's a 4.5-inch bolt spacing, or a, you know, 4.5. So what? If I order wheels for this, I know that it's a 5-lug with 4.5-inch bolt pattern. It's exactly the same as on the back of the car. So I can get matching wheels. I don't have to run a different size on the back as the front. I can get 4 matching size wheels, which was really important to me. So they even went as far as to think about that when they put this kit together. So if it sounds like I'm doing an advertisement for them, I'm not. I bought my kit. But I tell you what, man, when you're building hot rods, you'll be amazed at how much money you seem to throw in the air, and half the stuff you get doesn't work. So when you find a supplier that is supplying you efficiently and supplying you with quality merchandise, it's important to use them and share them and let other people know, hey, here is a place that you can get what you need. Okay, let's take a look at this. Now, you see that bolt right there? That is where your banjo fitting is going to go. And we're going to run that up to that right there. That is our brake line that's coming from our master cylinder. Those are the brake lines that are going to go from that caliper up to that. And there is the bolt after I took it out of the master cylinder. Notice there are 2 copper washers. One goes on the bottom of the banjo and one goes on top of the banjo. And that is very crucial to get that done. And now we're going to reinstall that banjo fitting in the top of that caliper right there in that hole where it goes. And there it is. We have it in. We're running it up, and it goes right into that fitting, and that fitting is bolted up easily into that bracket that came with the brake line kit. And now that is a charged system. Now I don't have it full of fluid and pumped up, but that system is ready to charge. Now if we walk around here to the other side, you'll see the same thing. Now I've got this one run really nice. There's the banjo fitting. If I get over it, there it is. And you can see the cables going back behind that kingpin extension and up into the T-joint fitting there and into the primary brake line from the master cylinder. As we back up, I'm going to trip over a log and almost fell down, but I didn't. And there's the car setting up, all finished. And you can see, this is me trying to show you how to measure the wheels, but we'll get to that at a later time. Hey, I want to thank you guys for taking your time and watching my show. I really do appreciate it. Like and subscribe if you feel like it. See you next week.